bad, buddy. Ah. I have a controller. Okay, good, we're working. Hi, Red Spade, Bobby, Mr. Beard, how are you guys doing? I'm having some... My display has been messed up. Give me one sec here. Probably look really weird from your guys' end, what I just did. Alright. You hear me okay? I hope my microphone just got knocked about. I hope I didn't break anything. Pretty damn pleased with yourself, huh? Oh good, I'm glad. This is... The camera actually, I think, is crooked too. Yeah, the camera's pretty crooked because my stand here is bent. High quality production here. So, you know. Indeed, Mr. Beard, indeed. I probably should fix my stand here. It's pretty, actually. No, it's not gonna get any better. I'll mess with it later. Whatever. Okay, well, we're doing some random games today. There's no real theme, just some weird oddities. I guess that's the theme. Oh, good. That's nice. Monday, they're always slow at the library. I feel like they're at my work, they're just like, hey, you know, it's Monday. Don't worry too much. It seems to be how it works. But except for email stuff, you guys gotta catch up with email stuff. But that's nice. You had a good day. I'm glad. That's great. So this game here is King Edwin's Adventure. Graphics by the Lady Nita and Miles O. The Forest, programmed by Sir Robert Bonifacio. Okay. As you might notice, this is a Color Dreams game, the company that eventually did the Bible games. To give you an idea of their production quality, look at this manual. This is the original manual. Yeah, it looks like it's some Xeroxed paper. No, not even joking. Like, from a crappy office copy machine. I don't know, maybe this is a copy, but... Anyway, let's see what the manual has to say for itself. Probably someone's husband, though, yeah. Beneath our great oceans, a sinister plan has come to pass. They're missing a couple, an apostrophe there. Some creatures, nay, some beast, has the magical orb of peace in its clutches. It was, yeah. It's not. The game cover is good. It's like, okay. But, whatever. It was the last and most powerful of King Neptune's treasures. Slowly over the years, 8 of his treasures have been stolen, and now even the magical orb. Of course, it's always 8. The dark sorrow of the terrible deed blackens the hearts of those under the sea, because the orb was the last and most powerful of King Neptune's treasures. You, as King Neptune, must return the orb of peace to King Neptune's castle and restore peace to his oceanic kingdom. Enter this cool liquid world. A fantastic journey awaits you. Oh, I'm sure it does. So, arrow keys move you, start button starts the game, select is the map, A throws bolts and detonates them, throw bombs, hold button A and press the start button. Okay. Hold button A and press the start button to continue. That's probably important. You collect 12 seahorses to gain extra life. Some doorways need a key. Not much else to say. Looks like. Huh, some of this art here's... I'm glad you're back, Red Spade. Hope you're doing okay. You can see some monsters in here. That's fun, I suppose. Yeah, it's not horrible. Hints. Once you have, now that you have everything you need, you begin your quest. After you find all 8 of the stolen treasures, your journey will come to an end. Okay. It says, one of the hints they say is draw a map. Oh, there's a maze in this game, which means I won't... Yeah, there's a maze in this game, which means no matter how well I do, I won't beat it, because I'll never beat the maze. That's just how I am. Alright, let's start this. A dark tendril creature has stolen the orb and 8 precious treasures. Some believe its lair is in the inner chambers of the lost city of Atlantis. Help King Neptune find the orb and the 8 lost treasures. Collect as many as you can. To launch one, press B. Detonate a launch bomb, press A or B. Okay. Some creatures can be gotten using the bubble bomb. Light shot. Useful to get smaller creatures. Ricochet and gain extra power. Press A. Okay. To fire. Find these hidden treasures. Great. Okay. And as usual for a Color Dreams game, the frame rate's weird and not right. It's like these Color Dreams games all run in some weird video mode. You guys won't be able to tell this, but it's like this game is running at 30 frames a second rather than 60. Which is weird for a Nintendo game, because most Nintendo games run at 60 frames a second. So, whatever. Door, I guess. Whoops. That was a crown. I guess I'm supposed to get that. Okay. And we probably need to kill this thing, right? It hit me somehow, but I don't know how. Great. Why? Is that just money? I guess that's good. Whoa. Holy crap, that thing's... What? Okay. Oh. Wow, the projectiles in this game are the same color as some of the background elements. That's really irritating. Thing just invincible? That was a pickup. I don't know how you're supposed to know that, but alright, we'll keep moving. Yeah, you're King Neptune trying to retrieve treasures that were stolen by a tentacled monster of some kind? It's pretty vague, the storyline. I don't know who King... King Neptune, by the way, for those not as up on their mythology... Wait, isn't it? Neptune would be, Poseidon. I can never remember, the Roman and Greek equivalents. Like, I know Jupiter is, Zeus, and Mars is Ares, and Venus is Aphrodite. But then it's kind of like... Pluto is Hades. Who's Uranus? Which god? I don't know. Yeah. You never know what... I guess red is bad. That's the lesson we're learning here. Anything that's red is bad. Which, you know, fair enough, I guess. So these are some ugly-ass backgrounds, if I may say so. Ah. Whoa. Ow. Do I just go right forever? I don't... This is... Ronan, welcome, by the way. This is King Neptune's Adventure. I am King Neptune trying to retrieve treasures that were stolen by some underwater monster, apparently. It was very vague. That, I guess, was one of the treasures? Oh my god. Don't tell me I have to go all the way back. That would be not great. Yes, apparently I have to go all the way back. Oh, good. Can I just stay at the bottom of the screen and just go left, though? Let's see. Just keep shooting. Maybe I will not get hit by anybody. Oh, no. That strategy's not working. It's not working! I already tell this game is going to be incredibly exciting. This, by the way, was a game I bought at GameCon, and I would be maybe even embarrassed to share how much it cost. This is actually a pretty rare game, believe it or not. I wonder why, right? 1992, this is late. This must be one of the last Color Dreams games, actually. Oh. Is that an entrance? It is an entrance! Hey, cool! Wait, what? Are those hammerhead sharks? What? Is that an entrance? Oh, it is! It's an entrance! Great. Oh, that was a pickup. What was it? I don't know what half the things are in this game. Oh, that's treasure right there, right? No? Don't I want this gold? There's just a pot of gold here. Or, I mean, a chest of gold, but I can't seem to take it. I don't get it. Am I supposed to do something here? Left. This looks like a door, right? What am I doing here? Well, I got these bombs. Well, that doesn't do anything. Okay. Yeah, I tried. I think I've tried shooting for everything in this room, and nothing seems to do anything. But I feel like there's then I went through. I don't get it. Is this a boss? Oh. Alright, well. Oh god. Okay then. By the way, watch this. When you go in through this door, if you hit up to avoid this guy, you leave the area by going back to the door. So that's pretty terrible design. Yeah, it's a pretty epic skeleton, right? How many lives do I have? Apparently I have four Oh, there's a map! Look at that! I can't tell if my bomb things are hurting him, because he doesn't, like, flash. There. That was one of the treasures. Okay. I like how his weapons are still bouncing around, by the way. that's pretty irritating. I feel like it's not too much to ask to have his weapons go away when he dies. Am I wrong? Alright. They're way too hard to hit. There. Jesus. I probably need to get a key still. Alright. So, money? What did the money do? Wow. So I have 3 of the 8 treasures, by the way. So I'm almost halfway through the game. Okay, look, this area, look at this. The screen won't scroll ahead of me. It only gives me like 1 inch of space. But the other areas of the game weren't like that. Just this area is like that. Quality game design right there. And what is the point of this area? Okay, so, oh, there's an entrance over here. Wow. Can I go down? No. No, I didn't. Are you down? You don't like King Neptune? What did he ever do to you? Hey, those things stay dead, though. That's interesting. Way too tough. I don't know what I just got. Oh, I got a key. Okay. So I guess now I can open that door in the other area? Alright. Yeah, this is some weird stuff going on here, for sure. I mean, I'm assuming that key was for this door. Yep. Alright. Oh, what? What? I don't know what that was for, but great. And where are we now? Now we're in the deep sea, I guess. Look how hideous this is, by the way. How bad everything tiles. Ah, this game's ugly. Whew. I guess it was a sea witch. I don't know. Actually, wait. That was in the that thing was in the manual. It's it's a sea wretch. I think the manual, the writing is really hard to read. I think it's a sea wretch. Alright. Is this an entrance? That's an entrance. What? Where are we? We're in open ocean. Wait, what? Whatever. We'll just... Where are we? Stop killing me, please. There. Great. Yep. Most annoying enemies. Their patterns are so weird. not a sea cucumber. Alright, okay. Up. It's ugly seaweed. Nothing like an ugly game to make you really appreciate what those great sprite artists could do on the NES when they knew what they were doing. Color Dreams, by the way, is, if you ever hear about them, they're pretty much the only studio of that area that really was indie. Like, it was like five guys in like an apartment building or something that made these together. I know they were really ramshackle, low rent kind of group. Yeah, you would think that, wouldn't you? You also think, being King Neptune, that I could just ignore them and, you know, blow them up with a thought or whatever. I am a god. Where am I? Okay. Might have been both, Bobby. I don't know. Starting castle, right? Yeah, that's my castle. I guess there's no reason to come back here. Oh, what? What? The dolphin says, only a crowned nobleman can remove the sword from the stone. What? Okay. I'm assuming that means I have to have the crown before I can get the sword, but I already have both. Where are we now? We're in the maze. Oh, this is the maze. Great. Basically, Poseidon. More keys. Okay. Here's a good example of this game. It's just like, that insta-killed me, even though I had life. Alright. Can't. Alright, I guess I need something special to get through that. Okay. Hurry to get there. Okay. Well, it's a maze. They weren't lying when they said that this was a maze. This might be where my playthrough ends. Yes, sirree. Yeah, you might be right, Redspade. But I hadn't tried this game yet, other than making sure it worked, so you gotta give it one decent go, I think. I feel like at some point I need to try every one of my NES games, and there's a lot of them that I've not done much more than test, and this was one of them, so one down, a lot to go. Ooh, money, hidden money. Oh yeah, you guys won't be able to see this, I don't think, but yeah, no joke, Redspade. sometimes the vertical hold of this game like messes up. And I know that's not a problem with my equipment, because it happens on... I have two different Nintendos that are slightly different, and it does it on both. And only Color Dreams games do that. There's something wrong with the video chip in them or something. I don't know what it is. It screws up V-Hold on some televisions. They're just, like, crappy. Even the hardware is bad in comparison to regular NES games. Really annoying. It's like the screen will slowly slide up and be cropped in half weirdly, and then it'll fix itself every so often. And it's more than one Color Dreams game does it. And actually, one or two of my Codemasters games do it too. I think unlicensed NES games. I died in the same place three times now. Alright. Unlicensed NES games, like, the chips on them are not as good or something. I don't know what it is. They don't work. They're a little flakier. Alright, well, I will switch games. I think that's enough of this one. Okay, what was next? Yeah, something simpler. Oh yeah, and look at this weird, ugly-ass cartridge here. Like, ugh. Baby blue, funky-ass cart. Oh, on the plus side though, I never noticed this. This is a former rental from Video Hits Plus in Kalamazoo, Michigan. That's nice. Redspade and a couple others may not know, I'm from Michigan, so yay! I'm not from Kalamazoo, but that's a couple hour and a half from where I used to live. Yep, Hattress. This is from, I cannot remember his name, the Russian designer of Tetris, who never really got money for it. This is one of his other games. He also made Hattress. And yes, this is Tetris with hats. Basically. I don't really know how it plays. Try stage zero. I'm gonna say yes, haberdashers are an untapped market. Hmm. assuming I'm trying to match up hats. That's my assumption here. I could be wrong. This is Hattress. I guess I should technically update this, shouldn't I? While that's going down. How slow that is. There. Yay! Yeah, I guess if you match up enough, they go away. Okay. I messed that up. Dang it. Oh well. That's fine. Four? Yeah, you match up four, so it is just like Tetris. Alright. I know it's more than four. Okay. Is it five? Five need a matchup, not four. Okay. Okay then. What? Another control, and I don't. Is there a limit? Oh, I can only do it so often. I can make that guy come over and swap positions of the hats also. Okay. I don't quite understand the mechanic, but you see there's like an energy bar by the guy, and every so often I can make him move the stacks. I did it on accident. Oh, crap. I didn't mean to move that over. That's fine. They do have pretty good beards. That bar fills up by them, so assumedly every so often I can do something with that, right? That would be my guess. And by the way, the different hats do make a difference. The top hat, it's harder to get hats around it, and it blocks left-right movement more. Cash in. I'll take a guy. What? What was the? Oh, I beat the level, I guess. All right. Ooh, a bowler hat. Well, that's exciting. Okay. Thank you. So, what can I do here? I don't understand what I'm doing. I lift it up, then what? I don't get it. I really don't get that. That mechanic. I need an instruction manual to explain it, but I don't have the instructions for this one. Viking hats would be cool, yeah. Well, I guess I'm doing that. Okay. Okay. And it's two different meters for two different people, and I don't understand what either one is. Certainly less intuitive than Tetris, a little bit, the mechanics. I'm betting the heads at least vary some, would be my guess. I'll do my best here to get at least one more level. Crap. Well, I'm almost one more level up here. Okay. Cash in. It's now looks like almost like a Groucho Marx hat. Alright. Sure. Why not? Or Charlie Chaplin, yeah, you're probably right. Now, what does this do? Explain this to me, somebody. I can just move them. What? Oh, you can swap them, I guess? Alright, well. Okay. The controls are just... Indeed, that's... You gotta concentrate in Hatteras, Buu. You know, you don't wanna put your hat in the wrong place. That would be terrible. I like the theme, though. I'd say that much. There are not enough hat-themed games. I think we can all agree about... Oh, I thought I'd get that over, but nope. Thank you. go. There we go. Okay, well that's ugly. Do that. There we go. What is cash for? Is that just points? Yeah. Even the meters on their by the people, I don't. Oh, another hat type. Whoops. Eh. All right. Too real, Tris. Too hat, too real. Extra hat thing may have killed me. Every option's bad. So now I have a guy up there. Does that mean I can use him? That's probably what it means, right? Yeah. Yeah, okay, you can just swap them. Just to you can swap two of them. The controls for the swapping are just poorly implemented. That's what it is. Great. Booyu, I think on that note, it's a little from column A, a little from column B. Mistake. Oh well. Do. just move this. No, move this one. There. There. But, and it resets the, and it gets rid of the one I had out. That's not what I wanted to happen. It's Dracula's hat now. How festive. Oh, he can just throw hats out. Look at that. I didn't know I could do that. Look at this. Well, that'd have been good to know a while ago. I will say the Gary Oldman Dracula does have a damn fine top hat. I'd say that much. I don't know what their endgame is doing. I don't know anything about this, anything that's happening. Okay. Yeah, that game's slow and weird and that's not awful, just seems kind of middling, I guess. Well, that is what hats are good for. I know that very well. Let's see. Okay, here's an interesting one we'll do next. Here we go. It's not Guardian Legend. Kingpin's after you. Yeah, Sega Genesis music, man. Oh yeah, they inject you. Oh god, they flushed you down the toilet. How terrible. Terminated. I could have sworn I did instructions for this. Yeah, 95. This is a late Genesis game. I remember this. And also, you can see this box King came in. It's cardboard. That's how you know Sega Genesis is going to be late, so stop doing these nice plastic boxes. Yeah, no kidding. Terminator. Yeah, here you go. When Dr. Kane discovers his company's plan to release a deadly virus into the atmosphere, his boss exposes him to radioactive matter, transforming Dr. Kane into the Ooze. Now just a puddle of toxic waste, the Ooze must slam through mazes and around obstacles as he seeks revenge against the company. The Ooze can jab with a slimy punch, spew toxic spit, or just absorb enemies into his sloppy mess. And look at that art. We could see it up on the display. We got like, looks like a 50s B movie. I do like that actually. A little bit digital, but it's still pretty good. I rented this when I was a kid, or when I was like 12 or 13, I guess. Okay, we can see the controls. What? Wow. You know, I appreciate what they're doing here, but I don't understand how to read this menu. This is not a very good options menu, guys. Don't know what that means. Alright, since I don't understand how... Yeah, I got that was a sound test. I figured that part out, but I didn't understand what the other two sides were. It seemed like one was a control setup, but I didn't know how to read it. So I'm just going to start the game. Hopefully that works out. Toxic Dump. I remember not being able to figure out how to control this very well back in the day. Because it has a weird control scheme. Because you're literally ooze, so... By the way, some of the sound effects in this are identical to Comic Zone, which is kind of weird. Yep, it's an interesting concept for a game. It a little bit. It's interesting. Thank you. puddle simulator. Is there any problems? I have no idea where I'm trying to go or what I'm trying to get to or what I'm trying to do. I don't. Everything looks the same. Oh, that looks like a thing. Exit. Oh, okay. So presumably I go in here, right? Alright, I guess that was the first level. Great. Toxic dump. Alright, great. Part two. That might be a password. I'm not sure though. Toxic waste dump, quite literally. I think I need to get an upgrade thing to go through those yellow barrels. Yeah, I might have. I remember there were TV ads for this. I remember that. So you might have seen some of those back on regular television back in the day. This is also a Genesis exclusive. Yeah. That's how you know it's good. I'm the first one, huh? First one ever play it? Guess it's possible, you never know. Although, I'll have you know, Booyu, I bought this from a guy who used to own a rental store in St. Louis, so this could be that copy you saw played, you never know. Going now. All right. going. Although, from the way the guy described his talked about his clientele, I think he was in North St. Louis. No, actually, that would work, right? It's quite possible. But instead of setting things right that once went wrong, it just gets everything all oozy, I guess. Yeah, that's fair. This is probably a password. Otherwise, why would they show me this? You know, the core gameplay and atmosphere in this is pretty okay. It's fine, it's decent, but like, the level design of this sucks. That's the critical flaw here. Like, everything just looks the same, there's no clear direction. It feels like an exploration-based game, but the exploration's not fun. And I also have difficulty even telling what can hurt me and what can't. Like, what is hurting me? Is it those poles? I guess the poles hurt you, but they're like, you can't avoid them. Eh. Question. I don't know, Bobby. I don't have an answer for that. They should have things that, like, suck me up into a container and I lose some of my body. The one guy's had, like, a flame attack. I guess you could say that's burning me up. Going around in circles here because I don't. I guess I just missed one of the things or like a little exit somewhere. Presumably. Where have you been up here? Thank you. hug this wall. Get everywhere we can go. Stop them. Hug in the wall. It's often an effective strategy in games like these when we get lost. Not always, but sometimes. Yes, I've been to all these places. Okay, here's a new area. Here is you grab these pipes. Grab it. So you don't get, you can move faster that way, I guess. Alright, fair enough. Fire's bad. Learn that. Am I supposed to flag all these? I probably am, but I don't know why. I have no idea what killed me. Something. Game seems kind of middling. It's not horrible, but it's kind of dull and repetitive, and navigating is annoying. So, no, I don't think that's weird at all, Bobby. I think I would agree with you. But I have a game that I know I like better than these ones, because I've played it before, but I haven't played it in quite a while, so I gotta switch it over. Yep, pretty much, Bobby. Alright. Okay. It's got a NES chiptune version of Shake, Rattle, and Roll. How bad can it be? And you play as snakes named Rattle and Roll. This game's adorable. So if you've never seen this before, I'm the snake. I mean, obviously. You get upgrades to make your tongue longer. The main mechanic here is eating these little pellets. Yes. Although Q-Bert already looks like it's on drugs to me. So what you do is you, you see my tail is glowing now. That means I have enough weight and size to go over here and hit this, which unlocks the door, and that's how you end the level. But I'm gonna go over here and kill Big. This thing is Bigfoot. That's actually what it's called. There, you get a one-up if you kill it. Yeah. Yeah, I was gonna say, I thought Imbronin had played this. I remember mentioning it. Yeah. It is a snack. I thought it was. Oh, I remember. Watch this slick trick. Chop. Thanks, Mr. Shark. Hurt, you lose balls off of your tail. Yeah, this is a very weird looking game. This is, oh, by the way, this is developed by Rare. So, I think this might be in Rare Replay, actually. I always thought the thing I just killed, I think I always thought they looked like a toilet seat. Got them all! Yay for bonus points! Time! Sweet. Controls are definitely weird in this, I'll tell you that. Like hitting up makes me go to the up and right. Hitting left makes me go, it's as if your controller is at a slant. Takes a while to get used to. I'm a plumbing snake. Yes, we'll go with that. Oh, crap. Oh, that was a waste. Oh well, it's fine. Stupid toilet seat. Oh, this reverses my controls. It's pretty annoying. But it wears off. Just annoying. There we go. Wore off. Okay, zoom. Eat some pebble things. There, I'm long enough. Yay! Yep, it's cute but weird. And I don't know if you noticed, it's two players simultaneous. You can see the other player has a thing down there. Whatever you want to call it. It's a good two-player simultaneous game, because you work together. Truly. Pretty sure that's possible to do. And if you both have you both have to weigh yourselves together at the end to, like, add up to enough weight. Whatever. Bonus. Back here. Oh, one got away. No. Oh, crap. There. Jerk. Yep, the whole goal is to make really fat snakes. Really fat, heavy snakes. I've never beaten this, by the way. I've gotten to, like, the last or second to last level, and it takes a really steep... There's really steep difficulty increase the last couple of levels. It's, like, much harder as it goes. Like, this is easy where I'm at right now. Bomb. Stupid bombs. Bombs. One thing you can say about this game, there is no other game quite like it that I have ever seen. Not too many games you can say that about. Jumps like this are where it starts to get a little tricky. The weird angle is what makes this hard. Bomb. See, like, it's this weird angle where it's hard to judge. Very deliberate. I don't believe this is a sequel. I think this is the first one. Ugh, and this jump is also annoying. It's a bonus. Alright. Cool. Take it. Got it. Sweet. Woo. 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 See, and there's this jump here. This is also hard. And I think, like, look, my time, your time is really limited, too. That's where a lot of the difficulty comes from, too, is just running out of time. Oh, come on. And see, all my things are gone. I have to go back and eat and go all the way back over here and eat more crap. Pretty harsh, actually. And you can see my time's running. Well, I mean, I have time because I died, but... Stop with the bombs. Couldn't make it anyway, I don't know. What? Oh yeah, now it's too far of a distance to fall. Ugh. Oh crap. I'm just gonna die again for running out of time. Look at that. Hey. Hit a spike. Got more time out of that, though. Yay. See, like... It's the perspective, weird isometric perspective is why this is hard. Love it or hate it. There, jeez. The whole thing when you spin around, yeah, it's pretty good. It's got a lot of character. Oh yeah, when you're playing this two-player, the screen won't scroll without both, so you have to do all this, like, you can only be one or two steps ahead of each other, so if anyone screws up, it screws you both up a little bit. Wrong step. Oh, Eh, whatever. Flying pellets. You think so, Bronin? Oof. Been a long time since I played this. Well, that's fine. Did you ever beat this in Bronin, actually? I was gonna ask. I never have. Gotten close with a friend once, but we never beat it. Oh. Ugh. Reverse controls. There. I think there's like 12 or 13. It's a lot. Great. That looks tough. Oop. Ugh. I'm back. There. Whew. Magic. Hey, Bronin, did you guys do the warp at the beginning of the game? Did you guys know about that? I was just curious. Most everyone seemed to know about that when I was young, but I don't know if everybody did, it was just people I knew. Once I die, which I probably will, I'll try to do the warp. Ah, stupid bell. Oh, time for my first continue. I think there's three. Oof. am I trying to go? What am I trying to do here? I don't actually remember. I'm assuming I wanted that, but I don't know what it was. Oops. Yeah, like I got this upgrade fin, but I don't know what it does. I don't remember. Oh, that's the start of the level. Whoops. That was stupid of me. I can't go that way. Yeah, I don't understand where I'm trying to go right now. I'm confused. Not helpful. Just when I already beat all this stuff. Yep, evil bells. Oh, there's the exit. Okay. Thing do? I must need it to get for some purpose, but I don't know what that purpose is. I thought it was like to swim up waterfalls or something like that, but it didn't seem to do anything when I had it. What does it do? Yeah, okay, I'm going up the waterfall, so how do I go up? Oh. Alright. See, I didn't understand that upgrade, how to use it. You go like this. I'm almost out of lives now. Well, that's game over, I think. Yep. Just real quick, I wanted to see how many levels there are. Apparently there are 10 levels, so... Snake, rattle and roll. Now let's see if I can do the warp. I'm gonna try to do the warp here real quick, just to show it, because it's interesting, because it reminds me a lot of the Battletoads warps. Same developer. Oh, I screwed up. There it was. Let's try this again. Ugh, so close. One more time, maybe. Okay.
Oh, come on. Well, if you get in that rocket ship fast enough, it takes you to level, like, 7, I think? It's, like, a huge portion through the game, actually. Which reminds me a lot of the warps in, Battletoads. So that's kind of cool. Alright, well, I got one more game. The game's frozen. That's not good. Action battle game of paramilitary pandemonium.
Indeed. Okay. Whoop.
By the way, I don't have it, but if you notice, there's two blanked out options. That's because I don't have a multi-tap plugged in. This is actually a four-player simultaneous game. Did we play this, Mr. Beard, when I brought my Sega Genesis over? I cannot remember. I might have brought it. And you can co-op, too. Co-op's actually pretty fun. The one problem with this game, which I'll get to in one sec, and yeah, your General Chaos versus General Viseria. Yeah, Viseria and Moronica. Some subtle humor in this game. You go to a battle, right, and you pick your set of troops, basically, and there's always four options. These five, these five, these five, or these two. And playing as the two is way more fun because you're directly controlling them. Here, I'll show you. You'll see. Yeah, I'm directly controlling them. Rather than... Normally you use things to move them. It's stupid. And you can switch between them. But watch this crap. This is pretty funny. You see, you can pause the game with projectiles in midair, and they continue moving, and they land and hurt the enemy. See? Boom. It's super cheap. Haha. They didn't properly freeze the subtitles. But, of course, it's 5 versus 1, or 5 versus 2, so this is not remotely a fair fight. Still gonna lose, pretty sure here. Even with my cheating. Oh, fist fight. And then they do these close up fist fight things, which are bizarre. Yeah, it's like a loose real time strategy. Boom. Gun is jammed. Yeah, and watch, you can do crotch punches though, see that? Haha, judicious cheating there. It's the way to win. Both at once, great. There. Good. Hey, I won, how about that? Yeah, it's an action real-time strategy game. But you're playing two-player, you each control two people. So it's 4 versus 5 then, and that's actually pretty fair because your control is way better than the computer's control. There are, to give you an idea, I'll try the, yeah, that'll do. It's like, you have a cursor and you move it around. Here, I'll show you, we gotta... shoot. I don't know. It always seemed really hard to control to me this way, and that guy got vaporized. Yeah, I'm about to lose here. Pretty handily. Crotch punch. Crotch punch. Oh, well, that was close. Hey, I won again. How about that? Yay, I did it. The enemy is running scared. Thank you. Stop the train dead in its tracks. Alright, we'll try that. Watch this. Boom! Haha! Cheating! It's so good. Grenades in midair. Haha. Boom, 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 boom. Kick in the crotch. Oop, I fucked it. Oh well. Hey, it's booty! Yay, we win! Yep, there we go, the capital. That was a quick one. Chaos wins! How about that? I can continue. I think if I continue, it's literally the same thing again, but harder. So. Bad news, General. The cowardly commander of the Red Dog Army's managed to escape. I think I was supposed to put a Red Dog trooper.
You're near the border!
Oh no! Yeah, I believe it's harder. General Havoc plans a counter-strike. No, I think they're just less stupid. Yeah, they're the same sprite color swapped. Yeah. Grenades. Yep. Gotta go for those dick shots. Like that. Like that. Yeah, I don't know if you can tell here, the computer is significantly better at fighting now. See, I actually lost one, finally. There we go. Interesting about this game, by the way, that I wish I had it. This had a thicker box, and it came with an instruction manual and a comic book. The comic book was like not a full-size comic, it was the size of instructions, but it was a fully illustrated comic. I remember the storyline for this game, because I've read the comic, is when they were kids, General Chaos and General Havoc fought over a comic book and it ripped in half, and that caused a rift that led to international war? It's a little vague. Anyway, though, I think I'm kind of done with this game. I beat the main thing, it's fine. I think there's three repetitions before you get to the real ending, but it's the same stuff over and over. This is more just a fun game if you're playing four-player, that can be fun, or two-player co-op is pretty fun. But single-player, I think it gets kind of old pretty fast. There's the War of the Bucket, famously, where the people fought a war over a bucket and it killed dozens of people. So... alright, well, I think I'm going to just... Well, it's 5 to 10, so I'm only a few minutes early. I think I'm going to call it here. Thank you all for watching my stream. Next Monday, of course, is the 1st of October. And there's 5 Mondays in October. Ooh! So I will be doing all horror, spooky type stuff for the whole thing. So that's exciting. I think I'm going to be starting with Castlevania 3 and trying to beat it, and I don't know how long that'll take me because it's really hard. We'll see how that goes, but I'll be doing that probably most of next Monday because it's really hard. Alright, thanks for watching, everybody. I will see some of you tomorrow. If I don't see you, I'll probably see you, All Spooky is always good, and I'm sure Bobby will like that. I hope you do, Bobby. And I do have a few other newer things that I might play too, and I have actually no I do have one surprise planned for Monday for the lols, basically, but that won't take too long. All right, good night, everybody.